in bahasa, energi dari ekonomi syariah itu akan mampu untuk menggetarkan tembok Cina. Energi ekonomi syariah itu akan menggetarkan Big Bang di London sana. So I will repeat again. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Yes, alright. Energi ekonomi syariah itu akan menggetarkan setiap ruangan, setiap AC ya yang ada di ruangan ini. Karena itu, so we will talk about Islamic economy. Now, awalan aku lakum jazakumullahu khairan ala hudurikum fi hadhihi al-jami'ah al-mubarakah insyaallah ta'ala wa khasatan ila duyuhin al-quram min al-Malaysia wa aidan min Singapura wa mudiruna fil jam fi hadhihi al-jami'ah wa sanian kama qultu yani kama qala min al-mudir anna yani iqtisad al-islamiyah laysa faqat yani fi tatbiq وأيضا ليس يعني من أصل الإسلامية لماذا؟ لأن نحن اليوم ليس في مكة ليس في اليوروب ليس في العربية لكن اليوم نحن في عنا جنوب شرق آسيا إذن أولا لابد علينا أن نفهم لماذا سنتكلم اقتصاد الإسلامية Why we study about Islamic economy is the first. Why? Because we will talk about our basic philosophy. If we know, we don't know about the Islamic philosophy, I think it's nonsense if we maybe practice in Islamic economy. So, please our slide first. Yes? Okay. يعني إذا نتكلم يتعلق باقتصاد الإسلامية هناك ماذا تسمى بالفرق يعني بين التطبيق وأيضا بين النظرية. لماذا؟ لأن نظرية الاقتصاد الإسلامية هذا كريم جدا ولكن في الميدان أو في التطبيق هناك مشكلة. أولا يعني عرفنا اليوم أن تطوير وأيضا تنمية الاقتصاد الإسلامية ليس فقط في إندونيسيا ليس فقط في ماليزيا ليس فقط في سنغافورية Komo deh ngan ayah nu di Ciawi, di Gajru, di Cibarengkok, lain eta. Yes, it's all right. Yeah, because if we talk about Islamic economy, today we talk about Hong Kong, we talk about Bangkok, London, New York, and other countries. It's important for us, this. The second is about if we talk about Islamic economy, إذا نتكلم يتعلق بالاقتصاد الإسلامية ليس فقط يعني مصرف الإسلامية. Not only about Islamic insurance, but today اليوم نبحث يتعلق بكيف المستشفى الإسلامي وأيضا المطار الإسلامي. And we will talk about Islamic gym. Everyone maybe from the boys go to gym. And I don't know, is the Islamic gym or no? So we need to Islamic gym. You understand? Okay. Yeah, it's all right. I repeat again. If we talk about Islamic economy, not only about Islamic banking, Islamic insurance, or not only about microfinance, but today we will talk about Islamic tourism or halal tourism, and also Islamic hospital. Islamic airport, Islamic gym, yeah, maybe Islamic swimming pool and other activities, the people activities. So the Islamic economy is too large. Because today we have about Islamic arts, example, Islamic management or management Sharia. And Dr. Levy will talk about Islamic leadership. هذه هي قطاعة من المجتمع الإسلامية. من الذي أسوتنا اليوم؟ نعم، عرفنا أن الأسوة يعني النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. لكن مثلا إذا نعمل في المكتب، نعمل في السوق، في أيضا في أي مكان، أين النبي؟ إذا هيا يعني كيف نعود إلى النبي as a trader. Nabi as a leader. This is the important for us. And the fourth, if you talk about Islamic اقتصاد الإسلامية, قد طاعت, يعني, I think it's, if we talk about Islamic or basic philosophy, it's still wrong. Why? Because, for example, masalah yani as-su'al, man alladhi razaqtaka? Man alladhi razaqta? Of course, we will answer Allah Azza wa Jalla. Lacking the problem, but the problem is man arrozi. It's a problem. And secondly, if we talk about Islamic economic also, we talk about fiqh mu'amala. Naam, fiqh mu'amala yani aqsam min al-fiqh. Idan labuda arumna fi qawaid al-fiqhiyya al-ada muhakkama. Kama kultu lakum, nahnu al-yawm fi'na fi janub syar asiya. Idan nutafiq fiqh mu'amala, laisa faqad fil mu'amala yani min Middle East. No. We are in Indonesia, we are in Malaysia, we are in Singapore, we have Al-Adah, we have Al-Urf. So it's differentiation in with the other country. Fahim tum? Okay, jazakallah khairan. And the second, I will talk about Islamic philosophy, fiqh mu'amala, fiqh al-Islam, sharia, aqidah Islam. This is the basic philosophy. This is the tawhid. How to practice our Islamic economy. We hear maybe last week that the director of Islamic banking, private Islamic banking, corruption. What's the problem? I think about our belief, our spirituality. Islamic economy only in the practice, but tidak tahu. It la ta'lam kaifa basic philosophy. This is the important for us. This is rancang bangun dasar falsafah. We know about Plato, Aristoteles, Ibn Rushd, and also Iqbal. It's the logical. But our, kita dari timur. Kita beza sikit lah. Kita orang suara Malaysia ya. Kita beza. Kenapa? Karena kita ada yang sudah apa? Islamic philosophy, Melayu philosophy, Sundanese philosophy, Javanese philosophy. Kita kena ada, kita wajib tu. Ya, kita tambah-tambah untuk boleh, kita boleh explore our country, our culture, to be the Islamic economy. Okay? This is the next. Our wajibat. Naam. Wa hadhil yawm yawm sa'idun jiddan. Limada hunaka indana yang atuyuh min Singapura wa aidan min Malaysia, nanu min Indonesia. Awalan, yani, I will invite our speaker. The first speaker is Mr. Dr. Muhammad Effendi. He's here from ICC. Okay, the second. Yes. The second is our inspiration, Dr. Dato' Aminuddin Abdul Wahab from Cyber Security Management. Let's come forward. The third is my Ustaz, Dr. Saifuddin Amin, M.A. Tafadol. That will be, inshallah, takkan lebih luar hati Arabia. Okay, alumni from Medina University. And also from Indonesia. Now, oh, jadi kepada ya. Jazakumullah khairan. We will senasma jayidan ya ta'alak bi kaifa tatbiq wa aidan aslu falsafati fi iqtisad al-islamiyah. Every speaker have about 25 minutes. Only 32 minutes. And audience, please ask in English or Arabic. Or maybe body language. It's okay.
It's okay.
Okay. Thank you very much. The first for Dr. Effendi.
Yes. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Ah, boleh di boleh dengar tak?
Boleh.
Oh, natural. Yeah, because the mic is very artificial.
Natural.
Terima kasih. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Ya, yang berhormat Rektor, ya, Dr. Joy, for inviting me to share with you some ideas, yeah, about some management principle from Islamic perspective. We'll compare the Western versus Eastern and Islamic perspective. Right, so I'm only given about 25 minutes. So right, I will try my best to cover some of the key points. Yeah. Jadi kalau apa-apa yang kurang jelas, kalau mau penjelasan, sila bertanya. Yeah, saya akan sebab apa budaya try to explain. Right, okay. Where is my son? Okay, before I go to that, let me talk quickly. Now, what is this?
Water.
What is this?
Water.
Water. Okay. What happened if I were to throw up?
Water is out.
Will it come?
Huh? Yeah. Will it come down or will it just fly off?
Fly off.
Huh? What do you think? Suppose I ini kan?
Come down.
Come down. Come down. Why? Apa sebabnya? Why?
Gravitation.
Because this is law of physics. Newton law number one. What goes up must come down. You must come down, am I right? Macam mana pun, he has to come down. Because this is law. Law.
Natural law.
Natural law. You like it or not, you have to accept the fact. Tapi kita tak tahu apa sebab-sebabnya. So this is one reason why we need to understand some basic motivational concept. Yeah, take for example this one. Okay, now these are some, mungkin kamu tidak nampak, let me just show you, right? These are some of the sebab-sebabnya yang boleh motivate seseorang tu. Based on studies done in the 1940s, 1950s. Oh, of course, these are Western concepts. But some of the concepts are still applicable. Yeah, so they have 12 concepts yang katakan, these are some of the factors yang membuat orang tu rasa senang. Seperti gaji, pay. Are you happy with your salary?
Yes.
Huh?
No.
Are you happy?
No.
Not happy. Speak to your rector. Yeah. Some people are motivated by status. You know status? Yeah. Ada name card. Namanya wah tinggi sekali. They are motivated. Some status is not important. Some are more important is. Please someone, you got to look at two things saja. Two things. The first thing he says is job contact. Apa tu job contact? If people want to be motivated, semua boleh dengar tak? Pasal motivated ah. Pertama, keadaan sekeliling mesti positif. The working environment must be
positif
lah. Seperti gaji mesti
bagus.
Ya, kalau gaji tak sesuai, macam mana nak senang diri ni?
Negatif.
Pertama, ketua medis efek. Jadi, gaji mesti kata dalam bahasa orang putih, equitable. Kalau nak compare, mesti compare apple sama apple. Tak boleh membandingkan gaji antara di sini sama di corporate. Berlainan sekali kan? So, kita punya macam realistik lah. Itu pertama kali ya. Dan, kawan-kawan serakan mesti bermesra. In other words, the peers must be happy to work together. That means the environment is very, very sesuai, very good. That's first thing. Kalau itu tidak diberikan, sorry. Right? You can never make the people happy. Tapi kalau ini sudah diadakan, the job contact has been given
tak semestinya, tak garanti dan seseorang tu akan rasa kepuasan. Tak semestinya. Apa yang sebab mereka penuh kepuasan, happy, motivated is ni.
Job content.
Job content. Apa tu job content? Kita tengok kita pekerjaan tu sama ada kan bermakna tak? Ada kerja tu macam meaningful lah bagi kita. Ya, ada kita buat sesuatu kerja untuk berdakwah. Kepuasan batin. So this is more important. Right? Jadi untuk motivasikan people, right? More importantly look at the job. The job must be challenging, the job mesti penuh manfaat, the job mesti ada make sense. Lah. Kita buat sesuatu yang kita boleh macam rasa persekolahan Tuhan kita telah dapat menyumbang kepada masyarakat. That's most important. But, tapi sebelum itu, yang pertama mesti memberi kepuasan dululah. Right? Kalau ini tak dapat, mustahil ini boleh mendapat perhatian. So you ask yourself, your job, are you happy that what you're doing right now? Is the job ada purpose tak? Is your job have meaning tak? If your job have no meaning, then you are just kais pagi makan pagi. Oh. Tak ada sebabnya. Yeah, so that's very important. Huh? Okay, let's go to the next one. So dalam Islamic perspective, there was a studies done in USA among the Muslim in United States in the 60s. And also in the 70s, who says that if you're among the Muslim employees in the United States, they are very happy to do the job, give them more satisfaction if they are given opportunity to do service to God and His community. Walaupun gaji tu tak begitu tinggi, tak apa. As long as they can do their duties, religious duties to God, and also for the family and fellow Muslims. That is more important than salary. So there are many Muslims in America yang letak jawatan because the company tidak memberi mereka kesempatan untuk beribadah. So, and this for Muslim perspective. And in fact, it's true. My friend work in Germany. Right? He also the same thing. There are many Muslims say that more important is this. Yeah, money also is important, bukan tak penting lah. Tapi more important is dia beri peluang untuk beribadah. Is it true? You are so safe. Yeah, the Islamic perspective lah. Yeah, but Western perspective, money is very important. Money comes first. Besides the job content. Okay, let's go next. Okay, are you seeing this? Very quickly. This called Maslow. To make people happy, number one, you must have physiological need mesti disempurnakan. Your basic needs. What are your basic needs? Makanan. Tak ada makan, perut kosong. You won't be happy. Muka moncong, masam. Right? Makan tak ada, right? Minuman. These are basic needs. Very important. So if you want to motivate the person, pertama, semua ada makanan yang patah ni. Atas meja semua ada makanan. Kalau tak ada makanan, semua buka muncung saja. Yeah. So that's the first thing, very important. This must be sempurnakan, satisfied. Tapi kalau ini sudah, once this is happy, sudah diterima, we look at safety. Kita ada rumah tak? Rumah sesuai tak? Is it safe to live? Tapi kalau makanan tak ada, who cares about bumbung rumah? What? Does it make sense? This is what Maslow says in 1954 when he did the studies. Okay. One, you got your safety and security need, you ask your social. Kita nak berkawan. Human being is like animal. We are social creatures. Yeah? We need to talk to each other. In the workplace, you cannot remain isolated. Semua mesti bergaul, bersera. Then we find, yes, we are happy to work because kawan-kawan semua happy, can work together. But, so our social needs. Once we have received our social needs, we want to have esteem. You know what is esteem? Yeah. Ego. Yeah. Kalau macam bawa kereta yang Mercedes. Walaupun kereta Toyota pun boleh. A to point B. Tapi tak boleh mesti Mercedes. Sebab apa? Wah, rasa proud, bangga. Betul tak? Kalau pakai apa mesti pen yang Mont Blanc katakan tu. Ya, kau pakai jam mesti pakai
Rolex.
Oh, Rolex. Ya, walaupun Seiko pun boleh juga kan. Betul tak? Casio pun boleh kan. Tapi wah, bermegah sikit lah. Dia manusia, mana-mana serupa. Right? Tapi kalau ini semua tidak diperolehi, ini tak important. Right? Dan sudah sampai ini, kita nak jadi yang terbaik sekali. To be the best that we can be. Self-actualization. Right? So we sebagai majikan, management, we need to understand that different people got different needs. Yeah, but we need to recognize all this need must be one step at a time. But people cannot rasa bangga kalau makanan tak cukup. Yeah, people tak akan rasa bangga kalau tak ada rumah. So one step at a time. Okay. Tapi sekarang ni basic need is more important here. Wi-Fi. Yeah, that's a basic need. Betul tak? Mana-mana pergi tanya boleh, ada wifi tak? Tak ada wifi, you don't go into the workshop. Dan more important, bateri. Ya, bateri. Wifi ada, bateri pun tak ada, tak guna, tak boleh pakai tu telefon. Right? This is life. Pasal kita bawa power bank. Mana pergi power bank mesti bawa. Ya, yeah, so these are the latest technology lah tuan-tuan dalam masa 21st century. This is the basic need of kita semua ni. You like it, no? That's life. Is it okay? But so quickly, like one Islamic perspective, quickly, I don't want to go very quickly. As a Muslim, what's important to us is the opportunity to work together as a big family. That's more important to us. Yeah, and also more importantly, right, is from Muslim perspective, again, our employer, it's a duty of the employer to take care of their own workers, right? That's very important. And finally, from Islamic perspective again, right? For a Muslim, what's important is not me. What is important is you. I want to satisfy your need first. You first before me. If you're happy, I'm happy, then I'll be a better person. Not to serve me first. For Islam begitu kan? Kita nak make sure that our sibling, our relatives, semua tu, alhamdulillah, better than us. Right? Then, insyaAllah, we can be together with them. Not me first, but you first, then we work together. Is it okay? Right. How many more minutes here?
5 minutes.
5 minutes! Okay, I go to the next one. Very quickly, yeah? I go to leadership. Very simple leadership, huh? Quick one.
5 minutes.
Okay, now definition of leadership. Very simple definition of leadership. Dari segi Western perspective, is ability to influence. The process of influence. What do you mean? Apa tu influence? Bahasa Melayu apa tu influence?
Mempengaruhi.
That's leadership. Your ability to influence people make you a better leadership. Now, if you look at this, huh? Okay. In 1978, this gentleman, Michael Hart, he did a research, right? It took him 28 years to find out the most 100 people in the world that is most influential. And he says, dia bukan orang Islam, huh? Dia kata, Prophet Muhammad SAW is number one on the list. Can you imagine that? In 1978, he did a research. Among the most 100 people influential, Prophet Muhammad is number one. When he give a lecture, people boo him. Boo! How can Prophet Muhammad? Kenapa bukan Jesus Christ? Ini betul pernah terjadi di London. And they explain. Prophet Muhammad stood in the middle of Mecca in 1611. And he said, I am the Prophet of Allah. Four people believe, his best friend, his wife, and his two kids. After 1,400 years, until today now, right? Number of Muslims has been more than 155 billion. takkan dia tu pembohong. Sebab selepas 1,400 years, right, people still follow Islam. Am I right? Can you imagine that? Dia tak mungkin berbohong. And not only that, tapi sekarang, billion of Muslim will not hesitate to sacrifice their life over one word that will hurt their prophet. Is there any one Christian who willing to do that for Jesus? Semestinya. He asked the people, right? Sekarang, all of us will defend our prophet, am I right? We willing to die for our prophet. He asked people, any one of you Christian who willing to die for Jesus Christ? Semestinya. It's true. That's why he said, based on the most influential people, is and this is based on this issue. He just come up with second edition in 1998, also the same.